हेलो हेलो हेलो, क्या कह रहे हैं?
ऑडिबल ऑडिबल
यस, इज दैट ओके? हेलो, इज दैट ओके? ओके, नहीं चल, ठीक है, ठीक है, इट्स ओके।
नहीं चल रहा ना, अगर आपको सुनना तो इनका स्पीकर को नहीं चलता, वो लोग भी आपसे बात करेंगे या ये सिर्फ आप ही को बोलना है?
ठीक। हेलो, आई वांट टू स्टार्ट नाउ। गुड मॉर्निंग। इंडीड सच ए ग्रेट प्लेजर टू बी इंटरेक्टिंग विद वेरी लार्ज नंबर ऑफ सिविल सर्विस एस्पिरेंट्स in a 3-day conclave specially designed for them by an academy and Hindu group together under the aegis of an academy summit 2020. I wish when I finish my talk many of you would be enlightened and helped in getting your answers to certain difficult things and you are able to prepare. I have therefore titled your preparation strategies for civil service exam, and I have said generally the competitive exams as affected by pandemic. Most of you are aware my background, I therefore skip. Now let's look at what has changed, why we are talking today on the kind of issues we are grappled with. The scenario is that you all have to leave the places where you were in preparing to your homes, and you did not have your material along with you, and you found suddenly that there is nothing to be done by you. A situation in which you are not too sure what to do. And it was believed in the beginning that as a country we are doing so well and it will be very soon situation will improve and we can actually start doing our preparations to be successful in most arduous examination called civil service. But in fact, the reality turned out to be different. We still are part of a pandemic. Many educational institutions, including IIT Bombay, has already announced that in this semester, all the learning will occur through distance and there would be no face-to-face contact with the students. So at least we are sure that next 6 months, we will not have an opportunity where we will do a lot of face-to-face. If our focus will have to shift on to utilizing the online resources for doing the purpose. Competitive examination is a different ball game. Luckily for all of us, unlike many states, civil service exams or the dates announced by UPSC are generally sacrosanct. It is only this year that the exams were to postpone. The prelim exam, the interviews for those who could not complete by 25th of March, and subsequent exams to be done. Obviously, since it was lockdown, there was no opportunity for the exams to be conducted. So there was always a fear when it will happen. There was always an anxiety in everybody's mind. What is actually going to happen? Luckily, UPSC always believes in the candidate welfare. So at that time, the requirement was that you should all be very safe. And I'm so happy that I'm talking to all of you who are safe, whose health is fine, and who are raring to go to prepare for civil service exam. As you are aware, that UPSC has already declared certain dates now. So this anxiety that how long you would be in a dilemma, though pandemic continues, has been resolved. The interviews of the candidate for the last year exam, about 750 students were left in March when the closure came. The interviews would begin from 20th of July. The prelim exam, which were to happen on 30th of May, will change to 2nd of October. And then the mains will start in the first week of January 2001. All that, if you notice, has make a change by 3 months. And my general belief is that 3 months in a human lifetime cycle is not very critical. And therefore, this pressure that something will be lost should be avoided on the minds. So therefore, once the dates are clear, then it is quite obvious that we are not in a confused state of mind. We are ready to prepare. We are ready to go and attack this exam and to qualify. And many times you want to use word crack, you have to develop a strategy to crack it. But then interesting things is happening. Because of pandemic, even for coming 5, 6, 8 months, certain restrictions have come. I can't travel. I can't travel long distances to have face-to-face classes. Even when I'm doing face-to-face and meeting people, a distance has to be maintained. So days are gone when teacher find that somebody is doing very well, he'll pet you and say, okay, wonderful, you're doing wonderful things. And when you are interacting with friends, and if you crack a problem, both of you are hug each other, this is missing. Yes, I know that body gestures, touch, is one of the aspects in which we transform and motivate people, but we have to live with it, that I cannot touch you. So that touch feeling of confidence will be missing. You have to compensate, you have to plan, you have to strategize. Mask has to be used. Mask has actually not cut down much on your life. It's only a kind of safety measure. I remember when, before even pandemic, in last November 19, Delhi people would use a lot of masks. And somebody who was doing coaching in Delhi or such big cities suffered because of pollution. So mask has become part of our life. So take this as one. Of course, this gives you a feeling that somebody who could recognize in the first go may not recognize right away, because mask cover your mouth, mask cover your nose, and sometimes what you can only see eyes. So it's like a competition. I remember when I was a young person, they would do competition given the eyes of people and say, recognize who is the hero. So maybe it's a very interesting game. Let your friend recognize who you are. Because many of them would recognize by your voice, which anyway will come. And that would come handy when you develop small groups. And civil service has been, the preparation of civil service has been preparing yourself, discussing in small groups. If there is a difficulty, try to go to your coaching center, learn from them, or learn from them online. So all this is there, and there are solutions, as I am continuously saying. Now, in universities, there is already a discourse. You must be hearing every day that how to make the students learn. Luckily for you, this is not a problem. Why this is not a problem? Civil service exam or UPSC exam, there you have to prepare yourself. It's much more of a lifelong learning for you. With the support system provided by the coaching center and the mentor group. And therefore, your learning approach is quite different than the learning approaches of the university students. The teaching methods in universities are very different. In May, in month of March and month of April, many universities started talking and teaching. But they were teaching the same way as if they were teaching face to face. And the net result and the feedback is that students did not lap and they didn't learn. On the contrary, in civil service, the coaching centers have evolved themselves in such a manner that they are trying to create a condition in which their learning resources, their material, their tutors try to adapt the new methods of online teaching in which you can understand things better. So teaching here becomes a guidance using the supportive technology. But please understand, there is already a hue and cry in universities that how to do an assessment. You already heard that CBSE exam will not happen anymore. 10th exam will not happen anymore. Many universities are passing students, but my friends, civil service is not passing an exam. Civil service is to attain a merit against a competition. Luckily for all of you, the process of assessment, which UPSC is going to adopt even now, is going to be similar. That means, on that account, there is no confusion, and you will continue to prepare in the same manner as if you were preparing earlier. You know that there would be an objective type prelim, that you know there would be a descriptive kind of main exam, which will consist of many papers, and that there would be a personality discussion, which has happened earlier. UPSC is hoping, and hoping truly, that by middle of the end of July, last week of July, you could travel, and they again would have a face-to-face interview with you, with the distancing done. It is possible in UPSC that there are 5 experts, including the member of the commission, and 1 candidate. You can easily accommodate in a safety mode of distancing. So you can manage distancing. Personality tests is going to be similar. The assessment process, therefore, has not changed. This is a very positive signal. There is no confusion about it. Now, obviously, I know earlier you would be motivated by self, sometimes motivated by close friends, sometimes motivated by peer group, and sometimes motivated by the tutor who liked you most. Because please also understand that the civil service is such a ball game where many, many people apply. Very half of them are serious candidates, and that number is very large. And all that, we select only 1,000 people. That requires a tremendous amount of motivation, commitment, hard work. But all this in the changed circumstances has affected you. It has affected psychologically. It has changed your behavior. I'll come to that later. You are missing the analysis which your coaching centers or your peer group does for you to understand that which question paper you must, which topic of the question paper you must prepare more seriously based on analysis of overall questions being done. Of course, they are not always true that the same would be followed. Commission can ask you any question anytime, because that's the beauty of a civil servant, that he prepares for eventuality which he doesn't know. And then the content availability, as I said, your promoters are doing. I have no doubt that you as an individual learner, unlike when a tutor would help you in drawing a roadmap, this roadmap has to be designed by you. That means you know your strength, do a SWOT analysis of yourself. Focus on strength. Forget at this time what was your weaknesses. Utilize your strength. Create a roadmap in a manner that you say that I want to become an IAS and I must be in top 200 or top 100 so that I become an IAS. For that, what you must do, luckily for you, you got 2 extra months now. The exam would have completed in 30th of May. So for those who have been now preparing, and some of those who are still final year of the exam, they have this opportunity. So there will be an extra competition to you as you're going to appear. So what has made it change? As I said, your personal behavior has changed. And there's an adjustment required at the place where you are doing. I'm quite aware that most of these candidates who are appearing in civil service, they come from middle class, lower middle class, weaker sections, rural areas. And the sole motivation is that you can do something to the people of this country. So there's kind of a motivation in your mind to do something. But then it's also true that you are not well provided, where when you are at home, you will have opportunities to have a separate room available where serious studies can be done. So you have to adjust to this change. In a behavioral change required in a home where there are 2 bedrooms, when there are bedrooms that there is no power, when there are bedrooms and there is no there's no connectivity. Now, these are the challenges which has emerged, and you have to overcome these challenges. You have to find out your mechanisms in which you can do it. You have to remain indoors. the challenges to remain indoors are enormous. Luckily, in certain cities, parks have been opened. When I try to tell candidates that in a day when you plan your day or time, do keep 2.5 hours to 3 hours for you to practice yoga, to keep your health, to walk in a park, to ease out yourself, to do meditation, and to get the fresh air. Now, when everything is blocked and you are at home, you miss all these things. So, to create an alternative for yourself. An alternative could be at home. But as I said, somebody told me the other day, a professor who was doing for university, which applies to your tutors too, that so far tutors, when educating you, your parents were not privy what has been done. Today, where homes are small and the tutor is teaching you, parents are anxious what is being taught. So there's a greater challenge that while you are studying, your parents are right on the back or on the neck. Now, this scenario, it was not there. You have to find out the methods, a space in which you conduct your studies. Civil service is a very serious study. It requires a committed time, committed space in which you can do this. And therefore, when you venture outside, it is risky. I won't say that till the government's permit you venture outside. But whenever you venture outside, please do take precautions. But it is essential that a fresh air is an essential requirement. When you walk down, you think about what you are in the day. So it gives you an opportunity to recapitulate what you've been doing. But sitting on a chair and a table, it's impossible. You will break down physically. You have to take care of that. Your mind has to be get away. I know there is a challenge to prepare civil service exam, but there is a simultaneous challenge to ensure that your health remains fine and that you are alive. That means you avoid a situation in which COVID is going to affect you. So take immunity booster things, including certain meditation, including certain green teas and blah, 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 which not all kind of Sunday sources saying, but the Ayush says that. So improve your immunity, improve your interaction, time for entertainment, avoid buster your stress, and that you have to do. Now what is then done? Who's your friend now? Your friend can be a chat group, which you can create online. But you can look at a lot of videos which are available. Videos given by your tutors, videos given by your tutoring academy, videos are given by experts. Videos are given by those who prepared past. So look at these videos. Look at the positive points on this. Please don't think that everything what video says fits on you. Choose the best thing out of them. Focus that into your own strategy which you have developed. So I am saying that you are learning the best practice, but you are not completely controlled by what they have said. You can't replicate it because you are different. Your expertise is different, your strengths are different. So what I'm saying that when you're on a chat, don't get frightened if somebody is doing much better than you, because you can do it. It's an exam right now to be written to be successful. Chat would come much later. All these chat would help you how people prepare, and if it sets into your strength area, you can do it very well. So don't get demotivated if you find that you can't apply this strategy. Apply those strategies which you think are part of your setup. You would have a lot of classes on Zoom, like I'm talking to you today on an academy website. You would have many, many chances to talk. I have spoken about 8 times now in the country, and one of them were about 3,000 people listening on Zoom. So there are possibilities. There are a lot of talks of people like me are available. Look at them. But these are people who have nothing to lose. They can sermonize at times, but they will also give you tips. Look at those tips which are helpful for you. Have remote conferencing with your tutors, maybe individually, and I'm sure some of the coaching groups, including your academy, must have found ways of interacting with you individually. Because even 10 minutes of interaction individually by your tutor gives you a level of confidence, because many a times, like a class, in a class of 60, if all of them are interacting together, many of you can't ask questions where you think it might be a very, very casual question. It may not be a question which people would say, yes, it is important question. We always worried in the class people will not ask questions. What COVID has done, I've already spoken to you, but I'll just cover that. It has caused disruption, but disruption in real life. I've touched what it has caused. But though it has happened suddenly, certain impacts are negative. But let me mention to you, it's a godsend opportunity. I've already identified it. What is that? That it has given you an extra time. If the exam was on May 30th, many of you who were sketchily prepared by that time now have 2 more months available to prepare. So the competition this time would be much keener for prelim exam. And as you all know, prelim exam is one where negative marks are given. So in these 2 months, please prepare from books which are very good. They are not keys or simple question answer books. These are books where you learn, and if there is a contrasting question, you can easily articulate an answer. So it's an opportunity for you. It's also an opportunity that you are forced to be more than 3 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours. Actually, now you are roughly 10 to 12 hours easily available. Now, what that would mean? That means you now have a calendar which can be prepared for 10 hours of very serious study, including study, taking test, revising what you have done, innovating new things, something which you have not done, redoing it. There is a time. So now instead of 6 hours, you got 10 hours available. Because when you are with friends, certain things you do when you even don't like it. Friends want to take a cup of tea, probably it's not required. You can quickly make your tea. Maybe your mother would make your tea, or your father will bring you tea or water. So you have more time. You have more time available per day. So if you count that per day time, you actually are benefited. So though it's a disruption towards a positive aspect. But I'm more worried about it discourse in this country, unfortunately. Firstly, let me say I look at things more positively. In my life, I always believed 2-3 months will not be great. God give me life. God gives you good health. God gives you more life. If you are in age group of 22, 23, 24, 26, even 27, it becomes 27 3 months, will not matter much. So there must not have been a human cry that the education would suffer greatly. My friends, you all are self-learners. The material is there. It can be taken to you. It can be mailed to you. It can be collected by you. You can study. It actually gives you more time. So I am against the discourse telling you that heavens have fallen. Heavens are not falling. You will have a great life. You will still be succeed. You will win IAS. You will make what you want to do. Maybe 3 months really. But then the quality in you would be that those 3 months lost, you make up in later. People make years of work. And I know somebody who got 3 attempts. He came out of 6 attempts. But he became a very successful civil servant. So please don't panic. Don't go by the discourse people are saying everything is finished. It is not finished. I look at things positively, and you are my part, all my candidates, because they respect me so much and they are keen to listen to me. The only point I'll say, please have a positive view. Don't believe in discourses. Believe in you. Believe in your capability to deliver, and that would be. Yes, I know. Some of the brightest students tend to get unnecessarily worried. They thought they may not get home state. How does it matter? Not always that you do wonderful things in home state. You can do much better things in a state which you don't know. Because then you try to learn about the state. There's nothing which is wrong, which you try to explore. Maybe you like to explore flora fauna. You like to explore the society. You also want the pressures of your own home state, where everybody knows you and he expects that you will deliver, and that you do something which you don't like to do in your life. So in a way, I would always prefer, I don't know why people prefer home state. I always prefer a state where development is possible. I'll prefer a state where people are forward-looking. I look for a state where I can contribute and people will respect me. Because they know that you are coming from a different state. And when you try to learn about them, when you try to learn about their culture, they have a lot of confidence in you. So while I know that some of the bright students are worried that now the competition would be large, whether they will get on that day something good, maybe they'll be affected by corona, maybe their health would be fine. Fine, all these things would happen. But nothing is going to happen if you go to a place in the northeast. Somebody asked me the other day, because I'm an academic, I'm a bureaucrat, I've done all things in my life. People expect me, what is that we are like to work in? And I said, the only field I want to work is going to northeastern work. Because that's my brethren waiting for something good to happen. So please understand that if you don't get your home state, nothing is going to be lost. You're actually going to make a great name. I look at one of the chief secretary of Uttar Pradesh, of Maharashtra, who was from Uttar Pradesh, and he has done a great job. People respect him, and he said, no, I'll not go anywhere. I'll be in Bombay or Pune. What does that mean? It means that people have appreciated you, they liked you, you can stay and make a commitment. So, my friend who are bright people, please don't bother. Also don't bother that what if not IS, what you can do? You can do anything which you like. Nothing has been lost. In future, learning would become online. In fact, if you look at what government of India said under Swavlambi Bharat, the self-dependent country, they have said in the next 1 year, 100 universities, the best universities, will be starting what is called online degrees. You can understand, therefore, if without going to the college, you can earn your degrees in future. So those who would suffer will not be able to select it. Nothing has been lost. They can simultaneously start doing their degrees in which they were interested. In fact, many students, they would be doing them after the age of 28, 29, 30. Today, it is possible to do simultaneously. Take a subject which you have taken as the main subject, start doing a degree in that area. Nothing wrong. So doubly education. We have to be strong emotionally. Please believe that there are parents at home. They are support. Of course, they have expectations. I know middle class parents have expectations. But please also understand they are great support. If there is a little stress, they are with you. Please therefore understand, don't be too pressurized. Understand their value being along with you. That's critical. What to do? In fact, when I'm explaining each point, I've tried to explain to you what you can do. In fact, you can do wonders. If you follow what I've said, you have not to worry at all. In fact, you do much better. Each candidate should be happy that they're healthy, safe. So that itself must be a very positive feeling in you. I take please promise today that in next 2 months, you will keep your health in a perfect shape. The exam gives you stress. Everybody giving you stress. Surrounding air is a fear. Keep yourself stress-free. Keep happy. Happiness is important. You can laugh, you can smile, you can cut jokes. You can see a Govinda film or whatever film which likes to. I prefer Govinda because he can make you laugh. So important is laugh. Don't look at the serious. Don't today settle watching a film where you are settling the life of the people. It will happen to you. You will be trained. You will have opportunity. Currently, maintain your equanimity. That's important. One should avoid losing time. I said there are 10 hours available for study now. In this time, please don't be on social media. Even when I was talking face to face to young students, I would say, heavens are not going to fall when you prepare, shut down your phone. Only tell people that you are available 1 hour in the morning, 1 hour in the evening. Unless you decide to have a discussion meeting in the time which is agreed by all of you. For example, today I'm an alumni of Aligarh University and we are doing Golden Jubilee. We can't reach there, so we started a group. And on that group, we talk at fixed 5:30 on a given date. That's the only time we keep our phones in a regular mode. Otherwise, there's nothing happen. You are not doing business when one decision required to change. All that you must ensure that if the people who are supporting you in preparation, such as the coaching groups, your tutors, your mentors, your friends, that they must be able to send you information which is going to be useful for preparation, that you should accept every day in a given fixed time. अदरवाइज प्लीज पुट ऑफ योर वॉट इज कॉल इज दी सोशल मीडिया. आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट सोशल मीडिया. वेन यू बिकम ब्यूरोक्रेट यू हैव टू डील विद सोशल मीडिया, बट इन प्रिपरेशन प्लीज क्लोज इट. सोशल मीडिया इज नॉट प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर सो कॉल्ड जी के. पीपल कॉल जी के, आई डोंट एग्री विद जी के, आई कॉल इज जर्नल स्टडीज. देर कुड बी अ क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू सो कॉल्ड जी के, बट द यूपीएससी वुड आस्क ए क्वेश्चन नॉट जी के बट इम्पैक्ट ऑफ दैट जी के ऑन दी पॉलिसी, द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन एंड द इफेक्ट ऑन पीपल एट लार्ज. दैट्स क्रिटिकल पॉइंट. सो प्लीज डोंट कैरी अवे दैट द क्वेश्चन यूपीएससी आस्क. इफ इट्स नॉट ए जी के, इट्स नॉट ए क्वेश्चन. इफ इट्स बीन आस्क दैट वाई चंद्रायन फेल बिकॉज लास्ट ईयर चंद्रायन हैज बीन डन, इट्स नॉट ए जी के क्वेश्चन. इट्स अ क्वेश्चन ऑन हाउ वॉट डज इसरो डू एंड वॉट ए सेटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन वुड मीन. सो अंटिल यू रीड प्रॉपरली, यूज गुड बुक्स टू रीड, you will not able to answer correctly. So avoid wasting your time. Maintain focus. Study 1 hour. Meditate 5 minutes. Recall for another 5 minutes what you have studied. Because the exam requires that you learn, you articulate, and reproduce on a piece of paper. What your coaching center provides you, 5 things. They provide you material, they provide you motivation and holding hand, they enable you to articulate, they enable you to prioritize, and they enable you to reproduce. In fact, they also do a 6th thing for you, is that you evaluate what have you done. So civil service exam is nothing but combination of these 6 things. So what you have to now do is that have the best material available. My request to all academies, my request to all mentors and providers, that please provide the best of the material which promotes self-learning by the students through online. Design questions your material in such a way that every half an hour have 2 questions asked and the candidate need to reply. That in your presentation, the candidate opportunity to show to you how much has he picked up, comprehension, has he comprehended what you have taught. So that's one of the problem in distance education. Improve that distance education model, which you can do because you have been doing over the years. Many academies are doing a wonderful job. In fact, many universities are trying to learn from them. How to prepare that material. Give that material to them. Let the material reach them. It cannot reach online, let it reach offline. The best university in the world called England Open University is known to deliver the best quality material to them. And students learn as better than as face-to-face class. So that's number one. What you do number two is that you read this material, but you comprehend this material. You don't think you have read. Some people are not serious, would think they have read, and some fake memories remain in mind and they think they have read. That doesn't help. You read the material, comprehend, make your points, bullet points, in a matter of prioritized answer. That if based on this material, if the coaching group has not sent you the material, you raise your questions, you raise 10 questions yourself, and then articulate these questions yourself. Since your books with you, since your material with you, check these questions. So you are learning, you are articulating, you are writing short points, you are answering, and you are evaluating. And when you are an evaluator, become a tougher evaluator. Because the idea is that out of 6 lakh people who appear last year, only 1,000 would be selected, 200 would be IAS. And you want to be an IAS, you must be a strict judge of yourself. And when I say, when you conduct your own test, and if you get 80% marks, please believe me, in an actual test, you will only get 60% marks. That's the level of confidence. And that is the preparation thumb rule. If you can do that, nothing on earth is left to be done. Keep these 6 mantras in your mind. I repeat these mantras, please note these mantras. Get the best material. not the material to the point, material which gives an option, because the objective questions are options, and options are so near to each other that the discrimination in among them, to create that discrimination become very difficult unless you read lot of material. So please don't go by material which is only 10 page, 20 page, 30 page. Read, must read 3 books, 4 books, a clear understanding of them. And then only then you can discriminate. And if you discriminate properly, you will not guess, and therefore negative marks will not come. I am therefore requesting, please get the best material. On the material, comprehend. Make your points on priority. Which is the first point which will impact the teacher? You become teacher now. You are now teacher and you are in point one. Will you be impacted by that point? That's more critical. The third point is, can you articulate? Discrimination is one. Main paper requires articulation. Fourth, the fifth, your assessment. And sixth, once you get an assessment, you rechange your strategy in such a manner that with you as an Arjun, the I is 200 IS. If you keep that in mind and keep motivating, use 10 hours, I would say nothing is impossible. I have done in my life throughout that. I motivate, I plan, I study and come back. Continue having focus. Motivation is important. And if there is no focus, go to a friend who will not exploit you. In fact, by definition, friend is not the one who will exploit you. Friend is only one who is with you in second. There are mentors like me who are always there. I got so many mails, so many phones by people. Sir, ye problem, what can I do? But that day somebody asked me, sir, I have been called for interview. How to book my ticket? Should I book keeping 7 days of quarantine in Delhi? Imagine a person going to quarantine in Delhi and he's from, say, Trivandrum. The life is so different. He really panicked in 7 days. I am asking UPSC that please create condition when they will consider they are coming on duty. They come for interview and go directly back so that they avoid. So please have friends which are good. They maintain your focus. They ask you a question, what have you done in 10 hours time? Are you happy? Evaluate your work. After 10 and a half hour, 10 hour when you walk, evaluate in walk time, what have you done? Your success of evaluation is most critical. Routine as you fix, and I already said, have leisure for 2.5 hours. The institutions, I know, most of the students who try to take civil service, they try to seek support from coaching centers, the coaching academies, individual tutors, mentors, friends and whatnot. Why they do it after? Civil service exam is kind of a mother exam where it is not what you learn only in the university. It is the culmination of all your learning in school, in your college, in your canteen, on your playground, on your interaction, on your reading magazines and newspapers, on your reading sets. Now, when you face the university exam, you are facing a curriculum which is defined per unit wise and questions are asked to cover the unit. So in a way, these are prompted questions to you and you answer, you think you are the best. And there is no elimination. It is possible in a class of 60, 50 can be 80% and above. And 180 marks, they can be all. But this is not going to happen in civil service. Civil service, even if you have 200 people got marks ranging, say, 200 to 210, all 200 will be in 210. The merit has to be drawn. And if you are 210 with 211 marks, you are out. So please understand that preparation for completed exam is very different. In coaching centers, academies must convince you that, number one. Number two, they must also convince that I am giving you material. Also supplement this material by anything which is very good. So quality books. But the problem comes in the data. People ask me, what do I with the data? My answer is simple. Use data only from authentic sources. I can't take data from a newspaper which is not properly authenticated. So there are government documents, there are multilateral groups documents, there are NGO documents. Triple, double check data and use that data. Because data is essential in articulation. When you do main exam, you have to use those data. If I am to say that there is a women harassment, how do I make a point? I have to give data, I have to give law. Which law does what? I must understand the issue. So data must be such which is correct, unbiased. And there are a lot of biasing done by a lot of people on a data to claim their own things. My submission to you, use correct data. Use interpretation done by the best of the writer. Once it happened that there was a question in UPSC and people misinterpreted as if we have tried to criticize Shivaji. If you read the question very carefully, the question was asked, what was his virtues under these kind of challenges which normal people have? Because as a king, as a Shiva, as a king, he was not only a fighter, but he also utilizing society to support him to become a warrior. He was utilizing the learning from people who will advise the crafts of the war. He will try to learn the trust among people for him. It's a similar manner. Learn from everybody. Get the best out of them. And only then the best points will come. Now, what the academies must do is what I've tried to do in the last 20-30 minutes. I tried to look at the total impact of COVID and all kinds of possibilities. Let the tutors understand very carefully that the simple discourse itself that COVID has become a pandemic and it will infect you must be understood in all its aspects. So 360 degree mapping by the tutors, by the mentors must be done when preparing material, when preparing questions, when preparing lecture notes, and when preparing any assessment things. Please try to understand. The second, the ICT is not only Zoom or anything. ICT has grown. There are many, many features of ICT. When it is not only sending data, it is directly talking to them. In fact, at times, yes, the point I'm making, therefore, the proper ICT structure, including if you can using ICT face-to-face class, I don't mind. But a very good ICT structures can be created. And I'm sure this is going to be investment not for today. In fact, this would going to be investment for future. This ICT infrastructure should utilize all the possibilities, the boards, the chat groups, the small discussion groups. All that should be possible if you do proper planning. As I've already spoken, course material to be redesigned, schedules to be redrawn. In fact, this is an opportunity for all of you. Since individual students, why don't you let the schedule which a student wants of their own, motivate them to design their own schedule and provide materials according to their schedule. And obviously, you are promoting self-learning. So in fact, it becomes one-to-one learning, which only ICT can support, nobody else can support. You need to connect them. Don't leave them as it is. And I'm sure most of you have not left them as it is. Otherwise, this summit won't have been there. This summit is there because you care for them. If you're talking to them. Challenges broadly covered. It's a learning for competitive examination, not the university examination. it require interaction because you have to learn from any source. Question may not be a textbook question. In fact, you look at the paper 4 in the main, which is called Ethics and Integrity. The question there is simple. Is an experience of life which you have to answer. And that, since you have not yet become bureaucrat, you only through interaction, learning their case studies, learning their what they have done in their lives, that you learn from there. So, interaction is a must. Broadening the horizon. If you talk to one person, limited view. Read more, see more YouTubes, more material, look at various aspects and choose the best among them. Discussion through 5 people, 6 people, 10 people, if possible. Unfortunately, in India, large groups can't discuss because everybody start calling, which is a tradition on a TV discussion where everybody talks continuously. But civil service interaction, a group discussion, is a very serious business. One must know what points he has to make. One must listen carefully what other points people are making and then modify themselves. The greatest part is, do I create a noise response? Noise response, if there are 10 points on a question, can I understand which is the correct point of view? Prioritizing your study in a point to convey to examiner and satisfy that you become a student as well as examiner, that what would impress him most is that you have to practice while practicing. That means prepare through past question paper, prepare through many question paper which your mentors and coaches and trainers are doing this, and develop a strategy of answering first the rightmost question, the first, next the second, the third and the fourth, and don't make one 5 to 6. Make use simple language. Don't try to be my dear friend Tharoor. He's such a great scholar in English. All that examiner want to see, whether the communication which you have made, does it reach the examiner? Are you ensuring that? When you present it, you think you have presented the best, but you are not ensured that what you have presented, it has reached to the examiner in the way you want it to reach. It's a great challenge, I tell you. I tried to do as a young student. I had to practice these questions many times. There would be no paper which I have not attempted 6 times. And then try to ensure, examine myself, give me marks 60%, and then try to see. Please do that. It's an evolution process. Interaction with two. Therefore, as I already mentioned, I mentioned this point, but I'm saying while preparing, please be away from social media. Though the libraries are lost, I know this. The current library is online libraries. And I'm sure most of your academies and coaching centers are part of libraries online. There's so much material lying online libraries that they can take a membership, and when you registered with them, they can let you access those libraries. So physical libraries have changed. The libraries have become online. Material is available. You have to choose material based on your strength. Though there is an uncertainty of date, but for this year candidate, it is over. Let me once again reassure that assessment would remain same, that UPSC would continue to have an exam every year. This will not happen like state, that this year happened, the next year won't happen. Now 2 or 3 mundane things. I've tried to cover everything which you wanted to ask me. Civil service, UPSC conduct 12 exams per year. UPSC is a benchmark. 12 lakh people applied, 6 lakh actually appeared. Prelim exam is a Herculean task. More than 1500 centers, maybe this year more. UPSC trying to ensure that you have exam is taken as a safe center and distance travel is going to be small. They will take full care. Don't bother about it. I can assure you they worry about you. Preparation civil servant is the toughest. Police forces is nothing but the CRPF, the CISF is that kind of exam which is done every year. Engineering service exam, 3 lakh people appear. economic service exam, 1.5 lakh people appeared. Railway officers exam becoming popular, some 10,000 people appeared. Defense service, many people appeared. Now this exam taken both by 10 plus 2 students as well as students are graduates. Forest service exam, prelim taken along with civil services, separate medical forest exam. We are all aware, the IAS and the IPS in the forest service become the All India Service people, cadre is allocated. As I already discussed cadre, talk to the cadre about you. Take cadre where development is possible. You may not be taking over state. Your contribution will be visible where you can make a difference. Difference can be made only when there is an acceptable atmosphere. In 30 years time, you can't change the atmosphere. It takes time. Medical service examination, nearly 3 lakh people appear. Geologists, about lakh appear. Section officer exam, many appear. These dates are fixed. Current UPSC will continue. Through civil service exam, 20 services of Government of India are selected. Two of them are All India Services. All India Services only we would select, but they would be placed along with the state for a large number of period of time. In fact, they would be on their rules. They will be working for them. They will be doing development there. They are implementing policy there. But as and when Government of India want to use services of you, they can invite you. And they have a selection process, mind you. They have their own benchmarks to look at what performances you are giving your cadre. And that, have you developed a mature attitude? Have you developed an attitude, an aptitude where you want to do good to people? And that you are developing efficient methods of working, or that you have improved your learning across. Then they will ask you to come back to the state. Roughly 30 to 35% people from the state are taken to the center. And that's why it's called All India Service. And this becomes very useful when you want to take a state project to center, because some of you are sitting there. So that's why All India Service came and is doing a wonderful job. Other services called central services, where they are directly with the government and government places them. And important them are foreign services, the central excise services, so-called revenue services, Indian audit services, blah, blah, blah. Civil service exam is a 3-tier exam. Prelim exam called preliminary exam. I already said it is an objective type paper, two papers. One looks at the art, science, culture of the country. That means it looks at the polity, sociology, political science, history, geography, science, culture, and things like that. Carry 200 marks. Now this obviously is not taught to students. I'm a mechanical engineer, appeared, I know. In graduation, I'm not told about these. The time when it was told was in 10th standard, 11th standard, 12th standard. And therefore, most of the centers which are enabling students, holding hand students for preparation, tell them, please refresh your 10th standard, 11th standard, 12th standard. Idea is not that everything is based on the idea, is that these are graduation-based questions. But then the foundation lies into where the history is taught, where geography is taught, where social science is taught, where constitution is taught, where how does the constitution work is taught, how the parliament is constituted, how elections are held, everything is taught. But if you are taking English literature in BA, the subject of English literature would be done. And that's why we tell you that first paper and the second paper, which is nothing but articulation on handling the numbers, looking your aptitude, looking your comprehension, looking your answering questions based on comprehension, that if somebody brings you a certain question to you and say that I give you, this was the situation in which a new collector was given. So somebody sends him a note of say 50 pages and say, sir, this is what happened, the situation is. These are my questions, could you help me? And that's called an aptitude. You look at, comprehend, and answer the question, which we done as a 10th standard. I remember when I was a 10th board, there was a full 20-30% questions on comprehension. So comprehension has been done both in Hindi, English, and any other material. Comprehension is not language dependent. Comprehension is that you read a situation, you understand the situation, and based on the question, you can answer based on your understanding the text. Otherwise, what happens? People read a book, but they don't know what they've read. They even forget what was the beginning and the end, and what was the message. So it improves your learning. It improves your decision making. And that's where comprehension is important. So these two papers, one knowing the country, other knowing the comprehension, the way the bureaucrats react, look at the number. If you are a bureaucrat, they will ask you, how many people are in COVID? In a condition which require a ventilator, which they don't require. Do you think if these numbers were not there, we were able to take policy decisions? So policy decision without numbers is impossible. So please forget that numbers are not important. Numbers are important. Correct numbers are important. So second paper, misnomerly called CSAT, is nothing but knowing the working of a civil servant. He handles problems, he handles the situation, he reacts according to the situation, and that is what we put in the question. We want to look at your integrity. Is that clear? Now, it's difficult. Please let me mention. When as a chairman, you remember, I brought all this change. I wanted both paper to be there. Some of the people who did not understand, for them, government said no second paper. They said CSAT is very tough, and CSAT was made only as a qualifier. Please understand, you are reading for a qualifier. Qualifier requires certain number. And its marks are not counted, so you devote some time. In my time, when qualifier was done, it was not qualified to the regular paper. People have scored very heavily. All students. It is neither the subject dependent nor anything. It was neither a mathematics, it was how a bureaucrat works. It is how as a human being you would react given a situation. But the difficulty in prelim today is that the merits is drawn based only 200 marks. All of us who are in academics, who understand, larger the number of marks, better discrimination is possible. If it was the marks out of 1,000, I can give marks of 990, 980, 970. So there's a discrimination. When I reduce to 10 marks, the 100 marks, they become 9.9, 9.8. And there's no examiner on earth which will do a 0.1 marking. It's not possible. Secondly, there's a negative marking. So one negative marks will kill you out of the competition. So now out of 200, there would be people sitting on one mark about 100, 150. Because out of prelim, I take only 15,000 students. So you can imagine, the prelim would be tougher based on one. So that's the challenge. So don't guess. Negative marking, tougher than anything else. Reduction from 6 lakhs to 15,000. The second is a conventional paper. Many paper, two are qualifier. English is a compulsory qualifier, 10th standard, having comprehension, grammar, and passage. This we have done all in 10th. When I look at this data in the country, 95% students have taken English as a subject on 10th standard. In any case, this being compulsory, everybody prepared. Now, I noticed that this was only compulsory, not added. I noticed about 9% students fail only in this qualifier. So to improve so that the student take them seriously, because most of the students take, since they do not have marks, they will in any case pass. So they don't spend time at all on qualifiers. Once one day happened that somebody came to my home, a professor known to me, and his son was educated in convent school. And can you believe that he failed an English qualifier? The point is that he did not at all spend time on the qualifier. Qualifier would have certain percentage of marks fixed, maybe 30, maybe 35, maybe 40, because it depends on the number of students they are going to reduce. And also imagine if you fail, all your effort down the line of the paper, which are four compulsory essay, gone down the drain. So these papers are compulsory to study. Qualifier in mother tongue, qualifier in English is a must. Now there's an added qualifier of the prelim paper called CSAT. So the merit is drawn based on essay, based on 4 general studies paper and 1 elective. Most of the students tend to spend too much of time on elective. Elective is nothing but only equivalent to 1 paper of general studies. Because each general study cover, like first paper itself cover everything which is done in the prelims, but more articulative. Point 2, 3 and 4 are exams which have multiple subjects in it. So it is not only one subject window. So I know many people spend a lot of time on the elective, and there are a lot of debate about which electives. I'll not go into detail today on that elective, your choice. But please, when you prepare elective, don't put disproportionate time. Manage time between all 4 of them on essay. The best student could get 150 on essay easily. But I've seen somebody writing an essay even getting a 0. So it's a serious business. It's an essay. I've created 2 essays in one. Instead of 1 area, you'll do 2 areas of articulation. Essay is nothing but laid a future direction. When you join Government of India, you are supposed to write at least 2 to 3 pages on a topic which goes to your Joint Secretary, or first to Deputy Secretary, then to Joint Secretary, then to Secretary. You can imagine essay is a training towards that. And therefore, my submission to you would be that you prepare them well. Minimum age limit changes. It is 21 today. So somebody who was in the final year, they have time. The exams are over, they will all be passing. They can continue to prepare civil services to end a month available. Prelim can be cracked. Main exam from January, the middle, after the prelim qualified. The maximum limit vary on whether you are general category, SCST or OBC. 32 is the age. Number of attempts have been changing. There's a lot of confusion, so don't bother. If you're a good candidate, everybody must make a choice to get into first attempt. That would ensure, if you're in a first attempt, that you make a choice that you become Cabinet Secretary, Government of India. You get the highest position. If you come in 2 attempts, you have a chance to forego the Cabinet Secretary post. If you have come 3 chances, you will hardly get into Secretary Government of India for 1 year. If you get 4 attempts, your chances to only become Joint Secretary at best, Additional Secretary. So there's no restriction. Government says you can become. But then you start losing your chances to get the top. So my friends, my interest is that you all become successful in first attempt. The data published by UPSC and by many newspapers say 15 to 16% get into first attempt, 32 get in the second, about the same number get in the third, in fact, less at 28, and about 12% get in the last attempt. I hope I've said my point. There are certain questions which I'll try to address. In fact, I try to address all your questions. Question number 1, planned strategy can be most productive thing during this time. But this was CSA strategy which I mentioned. Identify areas I already mentioned. So I've done that. These are the questions. What are the core qualities that board is looking in for an aspirant? Do you think the current syllabus and exam pattern is able to rightly pick the candidate? I thought what the commission obviously looks that you are a bright student. You have a thinking of yourself. You have a high integrity levels. The personality values are very high. They are reflected by many ways, the way questions are put up. They are not knowing your subject always. They are knowing the subject in the question. So in my view, the personality test is well designed. This take care of your learning from everywhere. Syllabus is designed in such a manner that we try to take best out of you. Because this is the only time when we come to know what have you learned in your university, what have you learned about a subject. And since the subject area today is such that there are 4 common subjects, the variability has been cut down. So 5 are common subject, only 1 is an optional. Unfortunately, candidate take to 7-8 kind of optionals. I don't know why. So I would say commission's test is able to clearly discriminate and take the best candidate out. Given the vastness of the UPSC syllabus, what is the strategy one should follow to compete efficiently, effectively manner? I thought in my talk, I mentioned each step. In my summary, because this is available to you, plan your time. Let syllabus be not like civil service, not like university, where question on one topic in unit can be one. There's no unit. So on one topic can be two questions, because that depends on how importance in that kind of system people suddenly, like, for example, today a lot of value on pandemic. So governance issues in pandemic, governance issue. So question can be all highly loaded on what are the impact on the major policy impact or emergency impact responses of people. Nothing wrong about this. These are not called the questions on the current affair. These are questions on policy frame. So a lot of civil service questions are keeping policy frame in mind, implementation in mind in the question attempted. What UPSC exam expect from the candidate at each stage? I thought I've explained. First and second stage, answer is clear. If you're a candidate, you know, for sure you know, what you would be satisfied the answer yourself. I ask a group of 100 students, please keep hand in a heart and see. When you come out with the answer to your the exam, do you know that you have done your question paper right? Can you believe me that 90% said yes, they know sure what have they done right? Will they be selected or not selected? If you carry this question, simple answer. I did this test first time when I became teach IIT. I came back to my room, put my hand on my heart, took a glass of water, took a breather, and then I said, try to visualize what I did in my 60 minutes. And then I said, am I happy that what I did? Do my students were listening to me? How much of what I taught they would have accepted? This, my friend, has to be done every day. You must do this every day. After 10 hours study, sit down, take this test. And if your answer is clear that you've done it, the answer is done. This is done each state. My last two questions. I think this is not correct. The question is wrong. As I already told you, neither the method remains similar. No competitive examination like to repeat the questions. When our chairman, just taken over chairman, lot of young IAS who became collector, they knew me and they said, sir, I can predict your question paper. And I said, do that. And they did it. And I therefore made a point, how come a paper who cannot discriminate and who is predictable can do a justice to a quality student? Idea is to choose the best. Idea is not to choose somebody who can prepare hard. I want persons who can work hard. I want people who can articulate. I want people who have intellect with them. And with intellect, can they discriminate? And therefore, the pattern of exam would change. And UPSC changes pattern every year. And therefore, they expect that in each of the topic, you would prepare seriously. And only an intelligent person can differentiate. So your coaching center must create that discrimination in you by giving different question. You must have heard an examination called GATE. All the colleges are teaching in the universities, but only few are successful in GATE, because GATE challenges your intellect. So it is not hardworking alone. It's your intellect which has been challenged. So UPSC challenge intellect. UPSC challenge your innovation. UPSC challenge your creativity. And if you are a creative person, only creative person can develop the habit of discrimination. And therefore, question number 4 is not correct. Commission looks in you. So question papers would change. Like, for example, I have an example. There's a question paper in geography saying question paper is a compulsory and question would be map. All I did, question paper was not compulsory. Map question paper was there, number 6. Question paper 1 was compulsory, which was other. People went to the court and said, the paper syllabus has been said is out of question. Can this be out of question? In UPSC, there's nothing which is out of syllabus. It's not a university exam. Teacher only teaches what's written syllabus. Here you have to prepare not in the syllabus, but what is the domain of that topic broad? In the for question number four, I thought is not tenable. Looking at the current trend, the question asked in UPSC, it appears that NCERT syllabus are losing this. I think this is incorrect. I've tried to explain. The first paper, the prelim paper require, paper number 2, 3, 4 requires your refreshing of history, geography, political science, social science. And knowing the country is a part. Please don't think, if you can do now, you can prepare, I don't know. After graduation, please teach them. If you can teach them constitution without going into 10 plus 2, nobody stop them. The commission wants you to understand country. Commission want to understand the constitution. Commission want them to understand the culture of this country. Commission want to know the ethos of this country. Therefore, the paper number 4 has come. So I'm not saying that something which the collector of Uttar Pradesh, say a district in Uttar Pradesh would do, the similar thing collector of Maharashtra would do, or collector in, for example, China would do. What do we want to know? What does my collector do to my people in this nation? Now this, I thought, has to be inculcated. If somebody says, you don't want to do 10 plus 2, please don't do. Who stops you? If you can educate them about philosophy, culture, please do. Friends, I have covered everything. I've taken a lot of time. There would be questions. Maybe you can send them on my mail in future. Thank you very much. All the best to you. I wish you best. Thank you. I'm ending my talk.